Welcome to the Moon, A Voyage Through Time. The Aga Khan Museum is proud to present this exhibition in celebration of the 50th anniversary of humanity's first landing on the Moon on July 20th, 1969. The exhibition looks at the role the moon has played in the lives of Muslim civilizations from ancient times into the contemporary period and to the very day we are talking in today.
The moon belongs to one and all. However, scholars tend to research it in highly specialized ways. So one of the challenges that we faced was to propose a different way of looking at the moon without getting too jargony or too hyper-specialized. Part of the task was to find some thematic zones for the show, including the moon in faith and spirituality, as well as in science and the arts. The section on the moon in faith and spirituality is a zone that we call the moon as wonder. In the Quran, the moon is called a timekeeper. It is the basis for the Islamic lunar calendar. And as a result, it also determines when certain kinds of ritual activities take place.
We have on display some beautiful astrolabes that are really complex scientific tools. When you look at them, they're really stunning art pieces, but when you understand how many ways they could have been used to understand the movement of the stars, to navigate trade routes across vast stretches of geography, understanding the direction of Mecca, or exploring the zodiac, they're really complex scientific tools, but they're also beautiful. That's important when you think about how science and art existed together in history.
Here we have Lady Moon that has arrived as a good sign. She was once part of a larger book known as the Book of Omens. These types of illustrated manuscripts were very popular as the year 1000 of the Islamic lunar calendar arrived. At this moment in time, anxieties were running really high because of the fear of the year 1000. That might make you think of our Y2K. Anxieties. In this particular instance, someone wanting to forecast the future would pose a question to the book, open it at random, land on the moon face, and the augury or the prognostication that you see above and below the painting informs that she is a good omen, that he should go ahead and embark on a journey, engage in trade, and he will absolutely be triumphant.
Voyaging through the themes of this exhibition, it is really important to remind ourselves also that the fascination with the moon goes back over millennia, and ancient civilizations all around the globe already projected their aspirations, their dreams, and their spiritual yearnings onto the moon.
The moon installation was a particular challenge. Art doesn't normally come with a manual, so we had to come up with a plan from the ground up to get the moon to where it is now.
No matter where we are on the planet or how old we are, we can all look up into the sky and see the moon and have our own personal moment with the moon. So when we come to this exhibit, we have moments where we can stop amongst this beautiful art and think about our own relationship with the sky. We can create star charts, we can have a tool that helps us understand the cycles of the moon, or we can pause and compose a poem or an art piece to share with others. And hopefully, once the visit's over, next time you see the moon, you look up, you'll think of ideas that we've explored here at the museum.